Khattab, he was called to come here by a companion of one of Ahl al-Ilm, Shaddad bin Aus, Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah, Khalid bin Walid, Sharakhbil bin Hasna, Mu'ad bin Jabal. He was calling Umar to come here. When he was calling Umar to come here, Umar ibn Khattab, when he entered the Masjid al-Aqsa, Aqsa were full of dirt and full of rubbish. So Umar ibn Khattab, he cleaned all the dirt and all the rubbish were in the masjid. And what he did, listen to this very carefully, my brother and sister. What he did, he built the masjid with the wood. He built the masjid with the wood. Yet if it was a stone, why he would build a masjid with the wood? Now, as our ulama mentioned, that Masjid al-Aqsa and the old city, it went through many earthquakes, more than 11 earthquakes. So the place was destroyed and was rebuilt, was destroyed and was rebuilt. And yet you and he and she come and be listening to lie, where this is the Mihrab of Zakaria, and this is the Mihrab of Sulaiman, and that the Mihrab of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, where all lie. And the most important things that you and me should know, that when our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was traveling in the night of Mi'raj, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا. الله عز وجل, when he gave the order for our beloved Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to travel from Makkah to Aqsa, when our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were landing in this Mubarak land where you and me are sitting right now, 124,000 Nabi, you are all waiting for our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Was Ismail alayhi salam, was Yaqub alayhi salam, was Yusuf alayhi salam, was Ibrahim alayhi salam. So wherever you pray, wherever you do your sajda, could be any prophet or Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, he stopped and he did his salah. Yet, as you go to Makkah al-Mukarramah and you respect it, yet as you go to Madinah al-Munawwarah and you respect it, you should respect Awd al-Anbiya. You should respect the Palestinian people that they're fighting behalf of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'm going to tell you something. You are here because we are here. And we are here because you are here. Very important that you should encourage yourself. You should come and visit Aqsa. Because Aqsa, Arbul Anbiya, the land of Anbiya alayhi salam, where you're going to be going to Khalil, where you're going to go to Bethlehem, where you're going to be going to Jericho. Wherever you go, Anbiya alayhi salam walked, Anbiya alayhi salam stayed, Anbiya alayhi salam was the way. Yet, the companion of Allah alayhim, before they used to come from the gate, what they used to do? They used to take the shoes out. They used to walk without shoes. They go, how dare we are walking in the land of Anbiya, where all Anbiya alayhim salam, we walk from anywhere in this place. Yet people, they come inside of the masjid and they start smoking. Yet people, they come inside of the masjid and they start fighting. Yet people, they come inside of the masjid and they start calling this liar and this one thief and this one and that one and that one. You need to do one thing, my brother. You need to have sabr and you need to have sacrifice, especially when you come to Aqsa. Remembering all the ulama back home, remembering all the scholars that we are not allowed to come to Aqsa, remembering all your Palestinian brother and sister that you live less than 15 minutes away from Aqsa, that you don't have the opportunity to come and read the Salatul Jum'ah today, read Salatul Isha, read Salatul Fajr. Yet we need to thank Allah Azza wa Jal and do shukr to Allah Azza wa Jal, that how Allah Azza wa Jal has been choose you amongst his ummah, that you are allowed to come and pray in Aqsa. So what the benefit, how your life going to be affect and change when you go back home. I'm going to end my talk here in this hadith, which is hadith Maymuna alayhi salam. Maymuna alayhi salam is from the wife of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Maymuna alayhi salam, one day she asked our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, aftina fi bayt al-maqdis. Aftina, what the fatwa you can give us towards that place? What the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded to Maymuna and told her, O Maymuna, hi'tuhu fasallu fi. Hi'tuhu fasallu fi. Hi'tuhu fasallu fi. What the meaning? Go to that place and do your ibadah. Do your salawat there. Don't go there and go to Dead Sea. Where the adab took place, do not go there and go start visiting the church. Go there and do your ibadah there. Go there and support your brother and sister there. This is the most important things that you do. Fasallu fi. Go there, do your ibadah there. Go speak with the local people, give them your smile, give them your love, and tell them you are not here by yourself. We are missed to you. We are our duty. And thank you for fighting behalf of the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Muslim al-Aqsa and the land of Sham and the land of Palestine, it doesn't belong to the Palestinian people. In fact, this land belongs to the entire Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So as our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he too for sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now the hadith is continue. That if you cannot reach there, if you cannot reach there, what you should do towards that place? You should send olive oil. You should send olive oil to light a candle in that masjid. And where the brother, they are sitting as a whale, where he say that whale, where we used to store all the olive oil, and when the God used to light the candle. Now, there is a light, there's a water in the masjid, then you have to send donation to the masjid. Sending donation, very important, my brother. How? How can I give my zakah? Oh, I know Brother Saleh, I'll give Brother Saleh my zakah. I know Brother Mahmoud, I'll give him my sadaqat. This is totally wrong. This is totally wrong to give anyone who comes to your zakah or your sadaqah, because you encourage for this habit. People keep asking people for zakah and sadaqah. Well, you can find this in Makkah, Mukarramah, Madinah, Munawwarah, wherever you go, you will find this. The best things, your zakah, your sadaqah, you lillah. There is a masjid, there is an office inside Aqsa, but you can go there, donate for your money, or you can put it in one envelope and just go inside with the box inside of the masjid and just throw all your donation and all your belongings.